To create a vertical well in Insight, go to the Well tab and select New Well. The Well Configuration dialog opens up and allows you to enter well header information such as the well name, the well status, the unique well identifier, UWI, whether it's a land or marine well, the Kelly bushing height, and the water depth. The UWI is the most important value and should follow government or corporate defined values whenever possible in order to match the records to their databases. American Petroleum Institute API values can be used if this is provided instead of a UWI. There are other parameters in here such as well number and custom display name, but they are optional and do not need to be completed. Click on Create Well to generate the well. Notice that the well does not appear in either section or map view. In order to display the well, you need to have a well path. Click on the Path tab of the Configure Well dialog and select New Well Path. It's possible to import a deviated well here, but I'm going to create a straight path as selected by default. Give the path a name such as vertical and type in the projected surface X and Y, coordinates or geographic longitude and latitude values. If the incoming data has a different CRS to the project, you can select the incoming CRS and have the coordinates converted to the project CRS. Finally, specify the max measured depth, Kelly bushing, the total depth of the well, and click on OK. The well appears on the map view, and I can now close the well configuration dialog. The well has not yet appeared in the section view, and if I zoom in on the map view, we can see why. Adding a measurement of perpendicular distance to the 2D line, the well is over 450 metres away from the seismic. I have to change the projection distance in the control panel to be larger than this distance. The well still does not appear on the time section, but changing to depth, the well makes an appearance because it's stored in depth and not in time. Now the well is visible. I can change some of the display parameters such as the colour and the path thickness. That's better. Notice the really useful option to show the exact projection distance on the section. Let's see if we can get this well displayed in time. To do this, I need a time depth table. Ideally, I should load some check shots, but I don't have any, so I'll create a simple table using the synthetics tool instead. Select a new well from the drop-down menu. Instantly, you are prompted to create a time depth conversion for the new well. Select the manual mode and type in a simple time depth pair. If you're not sure what values to use, simply put the total depth and a matching two-way time. But remember, this will only give an indicator and not the correct position in time. Click OK and create the time depth table. The well now appears on the time section and I can close the synthetic tool. The curve being displayed is the time depth function you have just created. And you can turn it off using the control panel options. Your well is now visible on the map view and section view in both time and depth. You are ready to start loading check shots, log curves, and interpreting markers.
If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight.